Tamagotchi Motorola has more wins here at the Sanctuary than Supreme League great.
And now it is time for our main event. Introducing first, weighing in at 210 pounds, he hails from New Branch, the unpredictable JGeorge.
The Sanctuary, where kayfabe is dead.
JGeorge came out here earlier and had some words for the congregation, letting them know what his mission is. Trotsky, Trotsky's back. How's your stomach feeling, brother?
Brother, what'd you give me today?
I didn't give you anything. I had a slice of that pizza downstairs earlier, but that was about it. Oh, man, maybe it was that sangria.
It's not the sangria.
I got to tell you, Tamagotchi Motorola hit one of the cleanest, nicest elbow drops I've ever seen.
Tamagotchi Motorola actually is the one that taught me the top rope elbow drop years ago.
Really? So you went to the Orient to learn from Tamagotchi Motorola?
In 2002, Samu took me over to the South Pacific Media Tour there. That's where I met Tamagotchi.
All right, JGeorge has something to say. Giving JGeorge the what treatment? The what treatment?
What's that?
The what treatment? When they say what? The fans say what? Yeah, they say what? Yes, they're the ones who say what? Because they want to know what? Yeah, that's exactly how they do it. They say what? The fans.
Why?
Because it's fun. They say what? It's fun to say what? When the wrestler's talking. They say what?
No, I'm asking.
Whoa, look at this.
They say, oh, God, here we go.
The Dirty Diamond T3 coming in with the head scissors off the top to start things off. And here he goes. Windmill. Beautiful standing dropkick. He doesn't even have his hoodie off yet. Hold on, wait a second. T3 making an impression. Monkey flip to JGeorge, who has to regroup. JGeorge getting compliments up here on his gear, reminiscent of Double J Jeff Jarrett. Whoa! Beautiful! Apparently, JGeorge having wherewithal to pull the legs out from under D3. That's ring awareness if I ever saw it, even if he is on the outside. You have to know where you are at all times. Under. Oh, catches him with a knee. Stuns him. He's out on his feet. If I'm JGeorge, I capitalize now. D3 was out where he stood. Only a two count. I think if he capitalized a little bit sooner, we'd be going home.
The crowd is coming alive here for D3.
Got a good crowd here tonight. They're into it. Off the drop kick. Oh, look at the Boston Crab or the Lion Tamer.
That's a Lion Tamer.
LaMarca would love seeing that move. Look at this. Now he's got it synced into a Boston Crab. He's got it in deep. Oh, look at that. He's sitting back on it.
He's struggling. He's climbing the ropes. Can he make
it? Keith Lee got it. Oh, look at that. JGeorge right back on the offense. Drives his posterior into this lower back of D3. John, what do you make of JGeorge's game plan here? I mean, all strikes, just getting in there, really just slugging it out.
It's weird in this smart strategy. He's keeping D3 grounded. He's not allowing him to fly, not allowing him to get into D3 zone.
Oh, now, crucifix.
One, two. No,
turn the crucifix into a modified slam. Oh, sunset flip. Comes up empty. Punches the mat. That's got to hurt. Might have hurt his wrist. Overhead belly to belly. This is the epitome. Hey, George, the bonsai drop.
I would definitely say he lacks the mass to get
it. Not as effective as it was coming from Yoko.
You know, 40 pounds makes a difference.
Big time. Man, he's choking him out with a foreign object. Referee's got to break it up. Bobby Heenan used to do things like that when he would get in the ring. Nice suplex. Trying to keep D3 out of the air. Wow, three amigos, he's rolling through. And again, let's go after the third. JGeorge is in full control now. I know I said earlier it was a seesaw matchup. At least I was thinking to say that it was a seesaw matchup. Fans are letting JGeorge have it. Crowd in the palm of his hands. Even I gotta admit that was pretty impressive. I might not be fond of his tactics. But look at this, he's going through for an Olympic slam. Roll through with an arm drag to D3. JGeorge on the outside. Here comes D3. What's he got for him? Wow, senton over the top. The flying crossbody, if you will. The Italian sensation really going sky high. I'll tell you what, he's one of the best high flyers in the independent scene today. D3 going up top. They're all about it. Big missile drop kick. That should be all.
This crowd is coming alive for the kick.
This is the clothesline. Rolls through. Beautiful DDT. Float over DDT from D3.
One, two,
three. No, he doesn't have him. D3. He is unbelievable. I mean, when you talk about the it factor, I could honestly say that both of the guys in the ring have it.
Absolutely.
D3 is on a roll right now. Once you get somebody like that on a roll, they come off the top with a beautiful moonsault.
He definitely folded up underneath.
He definitely could fold up underneath him. He might have torn something in his knee.
Oh.
And there's that viciousness, that savage mentality of JGeorge leading with a headbutt. Another headbutt to the sternum. Right hand. Fires back with a forearm. One of his own.
JGeorge.
Uh-oh.
Who is tougher? Who is going to take the most here?
They're going toe-to-toe in the center of the ring. Oh, cuts him off with a beautiful forearm. Oh, Pele kick.
Oh, my. D3. 1, 2.
No. Oh, JGeorge hanging onto the bottom rope. Referee David Stone was able to catch it. This one should be over, but again, that ring presence of JGeorge coming into play here. Outstanding awareness on his part. That's what you call ring generalship. Versus the Irish Whip, up and over, he's caught him. Whoa! Drives him down with a backbreaker. JGeorge, 1, 2, no! He hooked a leg. I don't know if he hooked it with everything he had.
What a main event here at the Sanctuary Stunt Studio.
John, I mean, ideally, either one of these guys could be challenging at any time for Mike Orlando's heavyweight championship, and I got to think a win here is going to put them in the running.
Oh,
misses a backcracker.
Yes.
Misses the backcracker. D3. What is this?
This is
a handstand. Big elbow drop.
It's over. Cover him. Cover him.
He's got to cover him. He's got to cover him. 1, 2. No! That was his... D3 gave JGeorge his best shot. He's going for it again.
D3's got to be thinking.
Look, JGeorge is moving.
Oh, no.
Cut him off with the knee to the face.
He's got it.
Scooped him up.
This is a problem. D3's caught. D3's caught. What's he going to do?
D3 fighting back. He's on top. He's perched. He's got him hooked. Well, it's over.
It's over.
But look at this.
It's over.
JGeorge again. That ring. The ring awareness. I keep saying it. The ring awareness. The generalship of JGeorge to know to the road of the apron where he cannot be pinned. Two opportunities here for D3 that did not work out in his favor. Wait a second, JGeorge was he did have something in his hand. He was just putting it back into his tights.
Oh, no.
JGeorge missile crisis. He's got him. This one's over.
No, not like this.
Come on. Oh, you got to be kidding me. Just when you have all the nice things in the world to say about JGeorge, we think he's turning a new leaf. He uses a foreign object to get the advantage and win this match.
Jabbing something into D3's throat that the referee not seeing it. I saw it up here from my vantage position. Then D3 getting hit with the missile crisis. I've been hit by that move. That is a move that can knock any man out.
Where's the pride in winning like that? They know, they saw it. The only person who did it was David Stone. Oh, now come on, JGeorge. Oh, he's just celebrating. He wants to put himself on a pedestal, both figuratively and literally.
JGeorge, quite possibly the most arrogant human being that has ever...
I'm going to be honest. I can't agree with the fans here, chanting you can't wrestle with JGeorge. He put on a great show tonight. He had a great matchup with D3, who, again, either one of these guys could be contenders for the World Heavyweight Championship at any point in time. I don't know where they're getting this from. It just, I will say that I don't agree with the way he won, but his performance tonight speaks in and of itself. I think had this match gone a little bit longer, it could have gone either way, but he didn't need to do that.
Look at him.
Oh, he's shaking the referee's hand.
They're telling him to hit the ref, and he's just shaking the hands of the referee.
Oh, no! Why is he giving them what they want? Rock bottom.
JGeorge is a despicable human being.
He marches to the beat of his own drum.
He didn't do that for the fans. He did that for himself.
Yeah, they just gave him an idea that he liked.
That's all that it was, and now JGeorge... swaggering around the ring, taking his pride in this.
D3, a valiant effort here tonight, but JGeorge, whether you like it or not, emerged victorious. We had a great night of action here at the Sanctuary. Not a lot of our usual competitors here. However, a fun night in general. Am I right?
Tonight was a fantastic night, Winky. We had five spectacular matches here on our Sanctuary Saturday Supercard. And I gotta tell you what, I can't wait till April when we have one show every single week, every single Friday in April. If you have not experienced this in person yet, April is the time to do it. Any Friday in April, come down to the Stunt Studio. What's JGeorge saying?